Hi everyone, this is Guido with Lenovo, and I'm here with the IdeaPad G50 notebook. Today we're going to be replacing the hard disk drive. The process will take us around 5 minutes, and it should be easy enough for anyone to do. The only required tool will be a Phillips screwdriver. Before we continue, we want to make sure we are protected against static electricity or electrostatic discharge. For more information on this, make sure you click the link in the description. All right, so to get ready to work on our machine, make sure you power it off your computer and you disconnect all the cables and accessories from the system once it's completely powered down. Then place the machine on a hard, flat surface. Okay, so we are ready, let's begin. So first thing we have to do is to slide open the security lock. Then we can pull the latch and then lift up the battery like this and then slide it out and remove it. All right, now we have to remove 3 screws. First, second, and the third. Then next, just put our hands on the cover and pull, so we slide it open and then we remove it. Okay, to remove the hard drive, first we have to remove 1, 2, 3, 4 screws. And here's the 4th screw. Okay. Now we have to disconnect the hard drive, just slide to disconnect. Then we can just pull it up and remove it. All right, before replacing our hard drive, we have to remove these 2 brackets. So we remove the screws. And on the other side, we do the same, we remove 2 screws. All right. Okay, now we take our new hard drive out of its anti-static bag, and then we proceed to install the brackets. This bracket, the bigger one, is on the right side. The right side is connector facing down, facing the table, right side, so here. The other one on the left side. So we put the bracket onto the hard drive and we align the screw holes. And then we do the same on the other side. So we align the screw holes. And we install the 2 screws. Okay, we are ready to replace our hard disk drive. Now we have to place the hard drive into position here and then slide until it's properly connected. Last, we have to install 4 screws. To replace the cover, it's fairly easy. We just place it onto the bottom case, flat, and then we push until it's fully engaged. Last, we replace 3 screws. We install screw 1, number 2, and 3. All right, to replace the battery, we just have to hold it this way and slide it in. Then we can lower it until we hear the click.
Last thing is we have to slide the switch here so it's secured.
And we're done.